Good day, my name is Sandy Robenheimer. I'm the Deputy Principal, Registration Services, and I will also be your program director today. Welcome to the first virtual graduation ceremony of Northlink College. A warm welcome to our Chairperson of Council, Mr. Adrian Strydom, our Principal, Mr. Neil Maggott, and the Executive Management Team, our guest speaker, Mr. Mawande Jaga, campus managers, academic heads, heads of department, program managers, and the SRC chairperson and deputy chairperson. Due to COVID-19 in 2020, we could not host the 2020 graduation ceremony. So this ceremony will acknowledge the 2019 and the 2020 graduates. I would therefore like to welcome and acknowledge our esteemed guests, our 2019 and 2020 graduates, as they join us from their homes. This is indeed an unusual welcome to all of you, and the first of its kind, as you are not able to partake physically in the ceremony, but I know that you are probably glued to your computers, your laptops, or your smartphones as I speak. So, don't forget to send us a shout out, or a like, or you can even post a congratulatory message to your fellow graduates via YouTube. On behalf of Northlink College, we would like to congratulate you on your achievement and trust that your transition into the next phase of your studies or your career will be just as great of an achievement. As alluded earlier, this is not the norm. But we strive to excel in the new normal, regardless of the current global pandemic. With this in mind, I want to acknowledge the many lives lost to COVID-19 over the past year. Sadly, one of our students who was supposed to graduate and walk across the proverbial stage today lost her life to the virus as well. Patricia Haynes was an outstanding part-time human resource management student who held an average of 89%. She was excited about obtaining her national diploma in HR management today, and we wish to honor her achievement. We wish to extend our sincere condolences to her family. Some of our own colleagues have succumbed to the virus. We fondly remember Mr. Nandi Fihla, an engineering lecturer who passed on during the early stages of the virus. And most recently, Ms. Lungelwa Mbude, one of our campus administrators. Can we please stand and observe a moment of silence in their memory, whereafter we will sing the South African National Anthem. Can we rise for a moment of silence?
Thank you.
you. You may be seated. I will now call on the SRC President, Ms. Portia Madumane, to render the devotion.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Portia Madumane. I'm the SRC President for 2021 at the Northland College. Thank you very much, Program Director. Chairperson of the College Council, Mr. Strindom, College Principal, Mr. Margot, members of the College Executive Management, academic, the staff as constructors of intellectual capacity of Northland College, support staff, parents, and fellow graduates, I salute you all. Graduates, family members, friends, and lecturers, I am delighted to be a part of this joyful celebration of accomplishment, the 2021 graduate ceremony of Northland College. As I stand before you, I feel the positive emotional energy filling this space as a graduate. Close one door and open another in life's journey. Graduates, if you are all apprehensive about what lies ahead of you, rest assured knowing that you are ready, your educational foundation is strong, and you are well equipped to go and out there to do your best. Today marks the day you have been waiting for you. All the hard work and dedication finally paid off, and as a president, I'm very proud of your achievement. Give yourself a pat on the shoulder knowing that you came, saw and conquered, and more importantly, you made your parents proud as well. As your fellow student, we have a deep sense of pride in our institution and its 2021 slogan say, excelling in the new normal. We will continue to move forward in spite of our circumstances. We have a deep sense of pride in the legacy that we, as students, we leave for the future generation. Graduates, the innovators that the country needs to enhance growth and development. It is a fact, the new will negate the old. Therefore, we will need to think beyond the present, become change agents in our beloved country. And the world, utilize your skills and make the change. As I conclude, I wish to pay tribute to parents and family members who sacrificed and supported the graduate during their time of study. All of you played a pivotal role by enabling them to realize their dreams to successfully graduate. Let me pay special tribute to our former student leaders. Graduate, I salute you all. Now it is time to kickstart your careers. I also remember to plug the knowledge and skills back in our communities as teachers. I urge you to go out into the world of work with confidence and believe in your abilities and skills that you acquired. And always remain a friend of Northland. I would like to share a quote in the Bible in Isaiah 60 verse 22. When the time is right, I, the Lord, will make it happen. On behalf of SRC 2021, I wish you all the best in future. Thank you very much, SRC President Portia Madumane.
Thank you, Portia, for those kind words of encouragement. I would now like to call on the College Council Chairperson, Mr. Adrian Strydom, to constitute the Assembly.
By virtue of the powers vested in me as chairperson of the College, Northland College Council, and in accordance with the Continuing Education Act of 2006 and the Statute of Northland College, I hereby solemnly declare this graduation ceremony 2021 duly constituted.
Thank you, Chairperson. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I now call on the Principal and CEO of the College, Mr. Neil Maggott, to deliver the Principal's address.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of our College Council, our Academic Board, the lecturing and the support staff, I welcome you all online to this, our first virtual award ceremony. In so much as a number of aspects in our business of further education and training over the past year, or maybe even year and a half, that we've gone through, we've had many challenging times to ensure that our learners receive the learning for which they've enrolled, The COVID-19 pandemic pushed our academic staff to unlock new skills, competencies, and methodologies in our transfer of knowledge to our learners. The fundamental purpose of education and training in general is always to adapt to our world in which we are to survive. I am proud to announce today that the effort made by our educators in adapting to new teaching and learning protocols that must be maintained under COVID-19 lockdown regulations were absolutely amazing. We confer today for the very first time in the history of college education the recognition of awards and qualifications on our learners in a new virtual way. Our learners who are awarded diplomas and certificates today are congratulated on their achievement and wished all of the best in the future of their chosen careers. It must be remembered, a challenge is for the purpose to achieve. As students, during your time at college, it certainly came with its challenges. But you have overcome the challenges you faced and achieved. And so you, your parents, your partners or spouses can be proud of this as you've reached graduation for 2019 and 2020 studies. Now, it must however be assimilated in your development going forward that to become the best in your chosen career, this graduation today is only the start or a milestone in the journey of your career. Experience in the world of work, future mentoring and coaching, and discipline while remaining focused will get you to the top in your career. Always remember, it is not what you do, but it is the way that you do it that will make you number one in your job, your career, or your profession. Our best wishes go with you today as you continue your journey from here on. May you continue to have success and reap the rewards of your hard work during your period of study at Northlink College. I congratulate you once more. Thank you.
Thank you for those inspiring words, Mr. Maggot. I love the phrase that you use, that a challenge is for a purpose to achieve. So if we could leave anything with our graduates today is to say, behind each challenge is an opportunity, make use of it. Thank you, Mr. Maggot. Ladies and gentlemen, I will now commence by articulating the resume of our keynote speaker. Mawande Jaga was born in a small town, rural town of Kobo Kobo, formerly known as Kaiskamahoek in the Eastern Cape. He is the eldest of five siblings and was mainly raised by his grandmother. He obtained his basic education in various schools in both the Eastern and Western Cape, including Ikambaletu High School, where he matriculated. He enrolled for a diploma in public management at Cape Peninsula University of Technology. He also completed an advanced diploma in public administration, a postgraduate diploma in small enterprise consulting, and he holds a postgraduate diploma in project management. Mawande Jaga started his career in the Department of Social Development as social development worker, a position he held for 3 years and was promoted to the position of administrative officer at the Department of Community Safety thereafter. He was further promoted to the position of professional officer in the City of Cape Town Municipality, responsible for a unit that consisted of 6 people. He joined Zibonele FM in 2014 as the Director for Corporate Services and was later promoted to the position of Station Manager. Under his stewardship, Zibonelo FM has achieved the following. The listenership grew from 161,000 to 231,000 in a period of 1 year. Registered Zibonelo FM as accredited training provider or academy under MICT CETA, Zibonelo FM Academy is providing the NQF Level 5 radio production course and a certificate in journalism. Under his leadership, Zibonelo FM received the following accolades. Best Listener's Choice Station of the Year, NCRW 2017. Ingoma Awards, Best Gospel Presenter 2017. SACMA Awards, Best Community Radio DJ. Best Station of the Year, NCRW 2017 and 2018. And Best Children's Show. A nominee in three different categories under the Liberty Awards for 2017, and a nominee in four different categories also under the Liberty Awards for 2018. He developed the Zibonelo FM mobile application for live streaming, which aims to help people who are unable to reach the radio station within and outside of the province. He led in different community development structures under the auspices of the Khayelitsha Development Forum, also known as KDF, where he demonstrated selflessness and dedication in community upliftment and plowing to the community. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you our guest speaker today, Mr. Mawanda Jaga, to deliver the keynote address to our graduates.
Good afternoon, everybody. The Chief Executive Officer, the Chairperson of the Council, School Representative, Council President, fellow graduates, parents, and distinguished guests, or should I sum it up by saying all protocol observed. It is with great honor and deep sense of gratitude to stand before you at this prestigious event, which is particularly designed to celebrate the hard-earned achievement. Upon receiving this invitation as a guest, I was reminded of a quote by our struggle icon, Oliver Tambo, where he said, and I quote, "The children of any nation are its future. A country, a movement, a person that doesn't value its youth and children does not have its future." We're here today to celebrate the bright future that was made possible by sacrifices of parents, students themselves, who emerge from impoverished societies that are faced with numerous social ills. In light of our Tambo's assertion pertaining to the youth of our country, heroes and heroines who sacrificed their life to ensure that there is democracy. In this event today, I find it fit to express my sincere gratitude to those who have sacrificed for the struggle of progressive education. Now, it is the responsibility of us all present here today to ask ourselves a very critical question. And maybe it should be a joint discussion between the academics, students themselves, and everybody, parents, and everybody who is involved in education. To ask ourselves is that the question that the education system we have today, is it responsive to the needs of our society? I listened recently in the debate that is going on, that is taking place in social media and elsewhere, where students are arguing about who stand chances of getting an employment between a student that graduated from FET College and a student that graduated from the traditional academic universities. The truth is, the NQF levels are equivalent, irrespective of which institution you graduated from. We want you as a youth of today to build economy so that the nation breaks the cycle of poverty, which is the most problem. And when we see, and every time we hear that there is a graduation, the society that is languishing in poverty tends to tend to inspire hope to ensure that will ensure that at least there will be a breakthrough in all the problems that we're faced with. So it then becomes irrelevant for us to engage on debate that makes us to argue on which institution are the best, rather than focusing on obtaining skills and knowledge that will develop the economy to address deficiencies that are confronting our society. So that debate is becoming irrelevant, whether you wish institution, but the reality of the matter is that the skills you possessed and the contribution that you are going to make in the market, in the job market. On this new journey, please take note that a lot is going to happen. You will get a lot of regret to inform you, no responses when you submit your application. Maybe a whole lot of things that will make you want to quit the trying and following your dreams. When you come across all this, you may be overwhelmed, but remember the effort you have invested in obtaining your qualification and why you choose this path initially. Remember your why. It is important. It is very important to be you because no one will ever identify with your problems, your ambitions, your goals, and the version of yourself that you aspire to be. Your life matters. The absorption in the job market is not a race. You may not be fortunate to get a paying job as the next person sitting next to you, holding the same qualification as you. However, be consistent in fighting for your dream. In the brief I got, I was told that there are engineering students in the house. Engineering remains amongst scarce skills that are in demand in our economy. To a large extent, studies have shown that authentic project would greatly enhance engineering through learning and reduce their retention, thus providing students with opportunities to tap in their innovative thinking towards designing, creating, and building, to use their skills for a greater good of our country. As the society, when we hear that there are graduates in Northland College that are coming from engineering department, we know or we become to get hope that our problems is going to be solved because we believe that engineers are here to provide solutions to all the problems confronting our society. I am the CEO of the radio station, but I cannot fix a broadcasting studio because I do not hold a qualification in engineering. But that's where engineers come in and ensure that that studio equipment is intact and is providing what is meant to do. So in essence, we need each other. If you hold a qualification in business and your colleague is holding a qualification, sitting next to you is holding a qualification in engineering, in order for you to have a business and a sound business, you need to ensure that you work together. Well, in conclusion, someone lied to me and said, if you become an entrepreneur, you will be rich, you will be able to feed your family, you will live in a mansion. Little did I know that success of an entrepreneur demands hard work, great administration, good networking skills to sell your brand. I admire all of you that you have achieved through your studies because you will use the knowledge and skills you have to acquire, you have acquired through your learning experience. And one thing that is critical in business is that you will need everybody. I think it is important that you communicate amongst yourself. Now you are graduates today, but life doesn't end here. You are entering a job market, which I've mentioned earlier, that you are going to get a number of rejections and quite a number of challenges that are there in respect of job market. But for as long as you work as colleagues, you work as a team, beyond this level, you will be able to make a breakthrough in the market. By words of Martin Luther King, the education, the function of education is to teach one to think intensively, to think critically. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. In conclusion, as you navigate your way to success, there will be temptation to take shortcuts, difficult moments where you feel like giving up. Now, it's very simple. Live your life in your own terms and make sure no one owns your destiny. I went through a lot in my journey of life, like being rejected by institutions of higher learning and going to school on an empty stomach. That's why my wish is to employ you all to get out there, stand firm to what you believe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Jaga, for that insightful keynote address. And yes, the question still remains whether education and training today is still responsive. But like you said, we need each other in narrowing that gap. So we rely a lot on industry to tell us what we are doing and whether we are still in line with what is going out there and whether we are moving with technology. And yes, the debate regarding TVET colleges and universities, their status and their comparison will still remain. I don't think that debate will end here. We will still have that debate beyond the next decade. But I like what you said to motivate our graduates. You said, be consistent in the fighting of your dreams. So we want to wish our graduates all the success, and we hope you can take a leaf from what the keynote address intended today. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2019 and 2020 will now be acknowledged for their hard work and dedication during their time of study at Northlink College. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please give the class of 2019 and 2020 a warm round of applause. Thank you. We will now acknowledge graduates who will receive the special awards or the top achiever awards, as we call them. These graduates are recognized for having the most outstanding academic records in their respective fields of study, determined by such factors as subject average across all levels of the study program. I'm now going to call on our chairperson of council and the principal and CEO of the college just to step forward as we are going to acknowledge these top achievers. Colleagues and graduates, kindly note all COVID-19 protocols must be adhered to when handing over and receiving awards. So please, I'm going to ask both chairperson and principal, when handing over and for the students who are going to receive the award, we will allow an elbow greeting first, but you are also required to pause for a short or quick photograph while maintaining the required social distance. So you will see the marking between the principal and the chairperson of the college council, and that is where you'll stand. So you are allowed an elbow greeting, but obviously you will then have to take a photograph, but maintaining the social distance. We will now announce the top achiever awards in the different fields, starting with the top achiever in utility and general studies. For the 2019 academic year, this student completed tourism N6 at Tigerberg campus with an average of 93.6% out of four subjects. The award goes to Jean-Pierre, or fondly known as J.P. Wenzel. Thank you, J.P. So our top achiever in Utility and General Studies for 2020, the student also completed Tourism N6 at Tigerberg campus with an average of 92.2%. The award goes to Deirdre Conradi. Unfortunately, Deirdre could not be present today and therefore we will not hand over that award. That concludes the top achievers for Utility and General Studies. The top achiever in business studies for the 2019 academic year, this student completed business management N6 also at Tigerberg campus with an average of 97.25%. The award goes to Karen Assure. Our top achiever in business studies for 2020 is a student who completed office administration level 4 at our Paro campus with an average of 90.57%. The award goes to Devon Peters. The next field of study, engineering studies. The top achiever for engineering studies 2019, the student completed mechanical engineering N3 at Wingfield campus with an average of 85.25%. The award goes to Johannes Brandt. the top achiever in engineering studies for 2020. This student completed mechanical Boilermaker N3 at Bellville campus with an average of 90%. The award goes to Fawaz Johnson. Unfortunately, Fawaz Johnson could not make it today due to a prior engagement, but we still want to acknowledge the student. Can we give him a round of applause? Ladies and gentlemen, our top achievers today received a floating trophy for their respective fields, and they were also given a 5,000 Rand monetary voucher from the college. Well done. Thank you, Chairperson. Thank you, Principal. Congratulations once again on your achievement. We wish you much success in your future endeavors. At this point, I request the Chairperson of College Council, Mr. Adrian Stradom, to dissolve the assembly.
By virtue of the powers vested in me as Chairperson of the College of Northlink College Council and in accordance with the Continuing Education Act of 2006 and the Statute of Northlink College, I hereby solemnly declare this graduation ceremony 2021 duly closed.
Thank you, Chairperson. And I'll call on the Deputy Principal, Education and Training, Ms. Rulaine Cunningham, to do the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon. Chairperson of the College Council, Northlink College Principal, honoured guests, top achievers, parents, guardians, and academic staff, all protocols observed. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. Firstly, congratulations to all the graduates and top achievers. You can be very proud of your achievements today. Orrin Hatch said, graduation is not the end, it's the beginning. So you are now going out on your adventure, you're starting an adventure. I would like to acknowledge the culmination of efforts by the many people who contributed to the success of this celebration. Our Master of Ceremonies, who did the opening and welcome, Mrs. Sandy Robenheimer, our Deputy Principal for Registration Services. Our CEO and Principal, Mr. Neil Maggott, thank you for your inspiring message to our students today. Our College Council Chairperson, Mr. Adrian Stradom, for the official opening and closing of this assembly. Our Student Representative Council members, our President and our Vice President, thank you both for your part in leading the ceremony, and a special word of thanks to Portia for the devotion. To our very inspiring guest speaker, Mr. Jaha, thank you for your very motivating message to our graduates today. Remember your why. Why did you study? Why did you come to Northlink? Why did you choose that career path? Said Buck, for the academic attire, we would like to thank you today. Nikkei, who are the photographers, thank you very much. And then a special word of thanks to the Northlink staff. My sincere gratitude to all the academic and support staff who contributed to the academic success of our graduates. These staff went above and beyond during COVID to ensure the student success during unprecedented times. It really was a crazy year last year. I would like to also thank Encore Restaurant. To our marketing team, a special thank you for organizing this prestigious event under the current COVID circumstances. And to every single staff member who contributed in some way to the success of this event, thank you very much. But today is all about our graduates, and I want to express our sincere thanks to each and every parent and guardian who encouraged, supported, and motivated our graduates during the process of their learning towards this end result. It couldn't have been achieved without your support. Graduates, we cannot ignore the 2 to 3 years' effort and often many sacrifices that led to the success that we celebrate here today. Michelle Obama says, and I quote, "The only limit to the height of your achievements is the reach of your dreams and your willingness to work hard for them." So in closing, go and be the difference in building a healthy, productive, and accountable society. Northlink College wishes you all the best in your future endeavors. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Cunningham, for that uplifting vote of thanks. It's a vote of thanks of note. You can agree with me. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the end of our graduation ceremony. Thank you for joining us in our very first virtual graduation ceremony. Please remain a friend of Northlink College. Be safe and God bless. Can we please rise and remain standing while the academic procession leaves the hall? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.